15. It's where our word will be coming from. Hebrew chapter number 3, verse number 12 to verse number 15. The Bible says, then the man said, you are in Genesis. Hebrew, chapter 3, verse number 12, chapter 3, verse 12 to 15. Beware, brethren, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God. I want you to look at that. Beware, brethren, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God. Verse 13. But exhort one another daily while it is called today, lest any of you be undone through the deceitfulness of sin. For we have become partakers of Christ if we hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast to the end. While it is seen today, if you will hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion. Look out of Egypt led by Moses, not with those who sinned, those who corpses fell in the wilderness. And to whom did he swear that they would not enter his rest? But those who did not obey. So we see that they could not enter in because of unbelief. The main reason that made them not to enter is unbelief. I want to talk to us on a very simple topic. I'm calling it assurance for winning. Assurance for winning. As you do whatever you do, are you assured of victory as you live the life you live? Are you sure that there is something good that is ahead of you? Last week, we were talking about faithfulness while waiting on God. Faithfulness while waiting on God. That was our word last week. And we discussed a few things that I believe kwa yule mtu ambaye alichukua kwa makini, it has been a word that is supposed to help you so that even as you continue with the Lord and you are waiting on him, you are able to every day be able to be faithful to God. You will discover that many people are so short term within God. Many people, they are in Christianity, but they walk with just emotions, excitement. Today they are excited, so they are doing something for God, they are so fiery. But there is a day that excitement is taken away. There is nothing exciting. And when there is nothing exciting, their faith dies. They are not able to do what they are supposed to be doing. Because at that moment, whatever is happening to them, it is not exciting. The journey of life has lows and highs. The journey of life has exciting moments and moments which are not exciting. To everybody who lives, it doesn't matter your age, it doesn't matter your education, it doesn't matter your background, there comes times which are exciting and there are other times which are not exciting at all in your life. And it is very important to consider this, to get to understand that as you walk by faith, it does not always mean that it will be exciting. That is why I teach and usually say, faith is not about how you feel. If you live your life based on your feelings, you will miss very important aspects of life. If every day you take steps based on how you feel, you may not be able to walk within God, because most of the times it is not about feelings. Faith is actually taking what the Lord has said as it is and believing that he will do it even when there is no sign that it will happen. That is why the Bible says that the righteous live by faith and not by sight. The righteous, they live by faith and not what they see. Because what you see may not agree with what you're believing for. We've just made a prayer that there may be clarity about the voice of God and the courage to obey the voice of God. But I would also want you to know that not every time the voice of God will agree with what you feel. There are so many times I have known very well what and clearly what the Lord is saying. But the things that are happening allowed me, they are so much contrary. The Lord has shown me visions, very clear visions, very, very clear visions, that I can be able to tell that this is God who has spoken. But when you get out of the vision and consider the realities allowed your life, the realities, they are not at all agreeing with the voice of God. Many people who walk with God, they don't develop doubts in the beginning. They develop doubts there in the midroom. Mwanzo unaanzia safari. Whether, by the way, not just walking with God, even marriage, you meet with somebody. You have loved this person and you've gotten into marriage and you're starting the journey of marriage. And at some point, things are not the way you thought they would be. And you start imagining, I think ni kama sikusikia Mungu vizuri. Sauti ingine inanzia kukuonyesha, it is like there is something you missed. And somebody who said very well and told people that God has blessed him. Someone who said very well that he heard the voice of the Lord. He even saw it in a dream. You come again saying, I think it was not God. Why does it happen like that? It is because most of the times, people are not following that voice that is supposed to guide them. And there is something that is missing in them. One of the things I want you to understand is this. When you follow the voice of God, the voice of God gives you an assurance of winning. The voice of God gives you assurance that it shall be well. Don't worry, that is taken care of. I can read your mind. Now, look at this. Look at this. It is God who spoke through Isaiah and he said, go tell the righteous, it shall be well with them. Go tell the righteous, it shall be well with them. Go tell the righteous, they will not lose the battle. Go tell the righteous, there is victory ahead of them. It shall be well with them. Currently, it may not look like so, but it shall not be well. But it shall be well. Let's consider the story that we have seen from the scripture. The Israelites have received the promise of God. And they are so excited about the promise of God. And Moses at this time, he is a powerful man of God. They believe in him. They are following him. They are telling him everything good. And they are walking after him, getting out of Canaan, getting out of Egypt to Canaan. They are excited by the voice. In the beginning, there are miraculous things that are happening. They pray and pull, something happened. When last week I said, when you are a young believer, God just answers to my own very easily. unafanya unaomba tu na unastukia something happens. Unamwambia confirm, unastukia ametokea kuconfirm. But ukisha mature, you get to the point where he does not come to confirm. Because at that point he knows, he says, my sheep hear my voice. So you are supposed to recognize his voice. You are not supposed to be calling him and telling him, Lord, come and confirm. So at that point you tell him confirm, he does not confirm anything. He just keeps quiet. At that time you tell him, Lord, give me a sign. He just keeps quiet on you because he says, this time you are mature. You are supposed to be the one who is telling others about my voice. And at that point, there are things that happen so easily. You tell him, Lord, do 1, 2, 3. He does it very quickly. There are other times you can tell him, now, Lord, do this. Ananyamaza because anasema, by this time, you are supposed to be doing this yourself. So the Israelites, they are excited at the beginning, and they got out of the land of Egypt on their way to Canaan, the land of promise. I want you to get this, the land of promise. They have a promise of God over their lives. They are very sure that in God has spoken to them. But somewhere along the way, things started happening differently. Somewhere along the way, things happened differently. I want you to know that in the journey, mambo hayatatendeka vile unataka every time. Actually, do you know, it is recorded in the Bible that the Lord chose to take them through the longer way, even though there was a shorter way. It is recorded in the scripture that God chose, not the devil, God chose to take them through the longer way. There was a shorter way, but God decided that this time, I'm not going to take you through the shorter way. You are not going through the shorter way. And I want you to look at this. Most of the times when that one happens, what happens is this. You imagine that God has forsaken you. You imagine that God is not with you. When the load become long, when what was promised has taken longer before it has become a fulfillment, when the Lord, it appears as though he has taken longer to answer to you, at the point many of the times what people do is this, they give up on God. And the Israelites now on their journey leaving from Egypt to Canaan, there were many experiences, and many of the experiences, they were not miraculous, they were difficult, they were challenging. And because of their challenges, they developed unbelief. And when unbelief happens, when unbelief develops in the life of a believer, what happens is this, the conviction about victory ahead of you, it disappears. The conviction about victory disappears. When you develop an unbelief, hopelessness creeps in. Believing or faith does not happen because things are all right. Actually, we need the faith because things are not okay. We need the faith because things are not aligning with what we desire. That is why we need to operate by faith, because whatever is in our lives is bigger than us. We cannot use common sense to deal with it. We cannot use basic wisdom to deal with it. We cannot use science to deal with it. We need God for it to change. And for it to change, we need our faith, because for us to, you know, engage God in whatever we are doing, everybody needs faith. And if faith is not educated, or faith is not for the educated, faith is not for them who have come from a certain background. Faith is for the people who have believed that God is real, God is able, God is faithful. He will do exactly exactly what he has said he will do, even when circumstances does not agree, he will surely do it. Then you look at yourself and you look at the future and you're seeing God doing something positive. You look at yourself and you're seeing where you're going and you're seeing the hand of the Lord walking with you. You consider your life and you see victory. You consider your life and you see success. You consider your life and you see a lifting. That is why I would want to say how you look at yourself matters a lot in the matters of your winning. How you look yourself. Listen, it's not about your background. It's not about the helpers you currently have or the helpers you don't have. It is not about what happened yesterday or what never happened. It is about the conviction that is in you, that you know and you know and you are sure about it, that bere iko sawa. That bere iko sawa. And what God wants to do in your heart today is to develop this conviction, this assurance that you will win. This assurance that victory is ahead of you. Listen, this is not an emotion. This is not an emotion. It is an inner belief. It's an inner belief. Bible says, brethren, beware. Beware. Be alert. Be cognizant of this. I jambo ikue dani yako vizuri. Ili ya kwamba kusipatikane mtu ambaye that there have been in any of you an evil heart of unbelief. I learned this one last night and I said, look at this. A person who does not believe, God calls him an evil man. There is nothing bad he has done out there, but he has not believed. So, Bible says that man has an evil heart. That's how an unbelief is bad. That's how an unbelief is bad. And do you know, being born again and not believing that God is able to deliver you, is able to help you, is able to change your life, is evil because you downgrade God. It is evil because you look down on the power of God. It is evil because you despise God and you're supposed to have the capacity to see the ability of God. You're supposed to have the capacity to see the power of God. You're supposed to have the capacity to see that no matter the situation, God is able to turn things around for you. So Bible says, you should be careful. You should be careful. Dear brothers and sisters, make sure that your own heart is not evil and unbelieving, turning away from the living God. Because when your heart develops unbelief, you turn away from God automatically. You start looking for help using other means. I said last week, this is what happens when we start losing faith in our God. Even in the way we live in God, unakutanga mtu ananzia kutafuta njia zingine. Because you don't believe in the word of God, so you start coming up with your own ways. Even as a preacher can become an unbelieving preacher. And instead of sticking to the word and believing God, that is why. Because of unbelief. Are you got back? Because of unbelief. Somebody will start looking for other ways. Ili mambo ya igiane. Mubili anaona sasa mimi nitawauzia mishumari mukajenge. Look at this. Unbelief will make you turn away from God. Unbelief will make you be unable to wait on God. Unbelief will make you look for shortcuts. Unbelief will make you do evil in the eyes of God. Whether you are a pastor, whether you are a preacher, an evangelist, an apostle, it doesn't matter the anointing that you have. When you develop, actually, signs of unbelief is when you start twisting the word of God to favor you. Looking for other things that are not right so that they may spice the message. Looking for other ways that are not right, even as unbeliever, you started turning from other ways. I said, it is terrible that in our day, the church, we are turning away by and by from the voice of the Lord. Na tunatunga vitu zetu. Watu wanatunga mavitu zao. Mavitu na zinatafutiliwa scripture ya kuzishikiria. Hili zikae kama ni za Mungu. Mpendwa, wacha ni kuambie, Bwana ni mwaminifu na atakuja. Mungu atakuja. Wacha kuona vile mambo yako. Bwana atakuja. Na atakuja. Atakukumbuka. Atakusaidia. Atakuinua. Atabadilisha maisha. Kataa kufuata njia ingine. Kataa. That you stick to that which is of the Lord. Because when the Lord comes, a day that will come, one day is enough to turn aloud the 10 years of waiting. One day is enough for the Lord to do something that will pay for all the years that you have been waiting. All the years that have been eaten by locusts. So the Israelites on their journey, many things have happened which are not very positive, and they have started losing faith. They have started losing faith. What happens to you when negative things happen? What happens to your life, to your mind, when negative things happen? How I desire and pray that even when a setbacks come your way, you get more closer to God. Wacha kujiondoa. Unajua watu wengine wanajiondoanga waende wakafikirie. Wengine wanajiondoa kidogo wanaenda wakatafute Mungu. Ni wapi unaenda kutafuta Bwana? Na ako na wewe. Unajua there's a problem sometimes we have. Can I speak about this problem? That now, and I pray that this one you will understand it well. Hiki tutunakuanga nayo ya kutafuta Mungu. Sometimes somebody stops doing what he is supposed to be doing in God in the name of nimeenda kumtafuta Mungu. Kwani amepotea? Nimeenda? Let's be real with our God. Let's be real with our God. The fact that there is something that is not all right does not mean that God ameenda kujificha. Because there are certain things, kuna vitu ambazo sometimes maneno tuliyasikia again and again and again and again, mpaka zikafanya tu can develop certain faith that is negative in us. Faith that is negative. They made you believe ya kwamba Mungu wako mbali sana. That in lazima uende ukamtafute. I wish you be able to know that there is no one that is closer to you than God. He is so close to you. And that is why you need to understand this. It doesn't matter the kind of challenges that you may pass through. God is with you and is real. Don't get to a point of unbelief. 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 Verse number 13. What does the Bible say? But exhort one another. What are we supposed to be doing? Exhort one another. Uplift the heart of one another. Start with one another. Stick with one another. Encourage one another daily. 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 One of the major ways of overcoming unbelief is being there for one another, encouraging one another daily. And I desire that in the name of Jesus Christ, you become that man and that woman who becomes an encourager. Encourage one another daily, exhorting one another daily. While it is called today, lest any of you be ardent. Because there are people who become hardened. Mioyo yao inakuwa migumu. Inakuwa na mioyo gumu. Ya kwamba sasa hata una, there are people hata waubirie. Nothing happens. They don't get any revelation. They don't hear any voice. While they are just there, they love going to church, but they blocked the revelation faculty. And it is very dangerous when you stop getting revelation. It is very dangerous when you stop hearing God. And when an unbelief develops in you, you stop hearing the voice of God. Even when you hear a voice that sounds as though it is a voice of God, you push it away. You push it away. Because kuna watu ambao wamejifundisha pushing away the voice of God. Sometimes he even speaks to you in your closet and you're so sure that is God. Lakini unakaa unajiambia God hii nasikia God hii ni wewe, but it is not convenient for me because you're looking for that which is convenient for you. Ile ambayo haitaharibu class, ile ambayo haitaharibu status, ile ambayo haitaharibu vibe. And because of that, sometimes we miss the voice of God, the opportunities that were there for you in God, you miss them because unbelief made you turn away. Unbelief made you turn away. And this is what happened to the Israelites. They got to levels of non-belief that every day of their lives they complained a lot. They complained a lot. They never talked again about how God is good and faithful. They talked about how the devil is following them every day. They never saw the goodness of the Lord again. And because of that, they never entered rest. Their promise was given and it was their promise. But they made the promise not to become a reality in their lives because they lost their faith. Because of unbelief. And unbelief makes them start looking for other ways that comfort. Listen, I pray that you learn kufumilia today for what is there tomorrow. Yeah. That sometimes unaona leo akuko sawa, lakini unashikiria tu. Kunatokea watu wanakuambia kuna mtu anaombeana mahali, anapeana manji, unasema apana. Hata kama kunaye, nyinyi edeni, mimi siedi, nitangojea Bwana, nitamfumi, nitashikiria Bwana, nitamgojea because ninajua atakuja. Haitaji manji, haitaji misumari, haitaji kifagio. Ah, he is able to come and he will come. Praise the name of the living God. That every time you bear the testimony, you carry the testimony. This is what made many of them die in the wilderness. Unbelief. Verse number. We are become partakers of Christ if we hold the beginning of our confidence in the first to the end. What we got from the beginning. We got it and we believed it. We followed it. But are we able to follow it to the end? Are you able to follow it to the end? The day that comes and it is not exciting. Are you able to ordinate to the end? That our confidence is this. That God is for us. Our confidence is this. Victory is ours. Our confidence is this. We will win no matter what. The last love will be our love. Praise the name of the living God. Where are you assured of winning? Where are you? When you think about yourself, what do you see 5 years from now? There are are people who are good. There are people who are very good. They are passionate. But their passion is just for a short time. They are not able. They don't have something called tenacity. You should have tenacity. What would we talk, say what we're talking about tenacity? Uwezo wa kushikiria jambo. Hata kuwe na nini? Uko na uwezo wa kushikiria na kuendelea. No matter the circumstance. No matter the situation. And God is impressed by people ambao wanaweza shikiria. Kama ndoa zitasimama, ni lazima tujifundishe kushikiria. Kushikiria. Kama biashara zitainuka, ni lazima ujifundishe kushikiria. Kama utasimama na useme kabisa, I have seen the Lord, ni lazima kwanza ujifundishe kushikiria. Praise the name of the living God. Assurance of winning. That you are assured within yourself. The Lord has given a promise and gone to fulfill the promise. The Lord has given a word and the Lord will honor the word. The Lord has said it and he will do it. He is not a man that you lie. Look at this. The Israelites, they have seen the power of God, law power, miraculous power. They have seen God shaking the heart of Pharaoh. They have seen God delivering them from the hand of Pharaoh. But they came to a place where they are in the wilderness. There is no food. And because of that, they complained so much until the Lord and to kill them. They forgot the God who was working for them. They forgot the God who was lifting them. They forgot the God who was holding their hand. They forgot the God who delivered them from Egypt. This God is able to carry you to the end. And listen to this. You will not end in shame. Yeah. Be assured of this. That unaketi mahali unajiangalia na unajiangalia na unajiangalia na unasema, nanjua sita malizia kwa aibu. Ninanjua Bwana ataniinua. And when you are assured of victory within yourself, even your conversion changes. Your conversion changes. When others are talking about how things are so challenging, you are going ahead of them and you're telling them, but the Lord will make a way. But the Lord to open a door. And listen, listen. Let me say something that I said, I think it's last Sunday, I said this. Most of the people, their trouble is this. You have not been able to develop person of faith. So when others lose their faith, you also get lost. Developing person of faith. So that when everybody is shaken, you'll not be shaken together with them. Praise the name of the living God. That the closest people to you may lose it. But for you, you are not going to lose it. You are going to hold the firm because you know and you know and you know. I am not the type that can be defeated. I am not the type that can be ashamed. I am not the type that can fail. Even though I fall, I will rise again. It is the man in the Bible who said, do not laugh at me, my enemies, because I am down. For even though I fall, I will rise again. So you may be down, but you're looking at yourself and you're saying, hey, nina ona mnacheka. Cheken leo kesho mtajitokelezea kuona maajabu ya Bwana sababu nitainuka tena. Nilichokipoteza nitapata tena, even a better one. Praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord. Look at Daniel chapter number 3, verse number 16. Daniel chapter number 3, verse number 16. When things were tough, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they spoke to the king, and they said to the king, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. Because now at this point, there is pressure that everybody bows to the gods of this guy, that everybody worships in a certain way that was modern way in those days. But these guys decided they are not going to bow to the images of the king. They decided they are going to worship the living God and they are going to live by the principles of God. And the king came and said to them, guys, I have heard what you have said. And what I'm going to do, I am going to make life very difficult for you. And not just making life very difficult for you, if you are not going to bow to this gun that I am making, you will be thrown into the fire that is made out 7 times. When you hear that, many of the people, they will say, use common sense, use wisdom. Wisdom manzi, Mungu anasaidia anga mwenye anajisaidia. You get to a point, the moment you hear somebody saying, Mungu anasaidiaga mtu anajisaidia, know that huyo mtu amelose faith. Na huyo mtu sasa anajaribu kutafuta shortcut. And I am sure there are people, cousins who are Shandrak, I'm sure walikuwa namtokrezea wanamwambia, hey man, use your mind, tumia school fees vizuri. Praise the name of the living God. I am sure there were all manner of hand vices that were coming to Abednego. And guys were telling him, oh friend, we don't want to lose you. We don't want to lose you. Look at yourself. You are young. You have a future. It's just for today. Why can't you bow? You make it light tomorrow. But these guys, they say to the king, we don't have to think about how to answer you. We have already answered. We have a little answer for you. Number 17, they told the king, we know that our God, praise the name of the living God. If that is the case, we know that our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace. We know that our God is able to change the situation. We know that our God is able to raise us from trouble. We know that our God is able to bless our business. We know that our God, if we stand right in the ministry, he will open the doors of ministry. We know that our God is able to save us. What do you know yourself? What is the conviction that you have? What is the faith that you have in your heart? These people, they are saying, they are speaking out their faith and they are saying, we know that our God is able to save us from the. And these people understand it's not a joking, it's not a laughing matter. They understand Nebuchadnezzar. Nebuchadnezzar was not a joking king. So they knew the matter was serious and urgent. But they were not scared of the threat. They were not scared of the shame. You cannot walk within God until you rise to a level where you are not afraid of shame. Because you are sure, you are assured of this. Within God, you will not be ashamed. The Lord will take away the shame. The Lord will take away the pain. The Lord will take away the trouble. They say, we know that our God is able. I want to speak to somebody this day. I don't know what circumstance you're in. I don't know what situation you're in. But listen to me. I know that our God is able to save you. I know that our God is able to help you. Don't bow to the devil. Don't bow to pleasure. Don't bow to pain. Don't bow to circumstances. Our God is able. You will not die, but you will live. Praise the name of the living God. It's time to be more firm in God. It's time to be more strong in God. It's time to be more excited in God. It's time to make our faith alive. I know, Kayaba Sanda Baraba, he will deliver us from your hand. He will deliver you from the hand of the wicked. He will deliver you from the haters. He will deliver you from evil schemers. He will deliver you from the plans of the devil. Don't tell me about ancestral curse. The one who we believe in, he broke every curse. Kayabashanda. He was the sacrifice himself. He broke every curse. We are free in the name of Jesus Christ. We are power that gives victory. We are power that delivers. We are Yabashanda Baya. We are not
of the kind that shrink back. Ah, the victory of God is upon us. The power of God is upon us. And I pray for you, child of God, today. You may be alone, but stand firm. Praise the name of the living God. Oh, this God did not call you to put you into shame. This God did not call you that you may be ridiculed. This God did not call you that he may make you a public display of failure. This God called you to change your life. This God called you to make you better. He is the deliverer. He is the healer. His ayabashandabaya. His anointing breaks even poverty. It will be broken. Poverty is a devil. Poverty is not of God. It will be broken out of your life. You get out of it. Ayabashanamaya. Look and see a better tomorrow for you. Look and see Jesus changing your life. Look and see Jesus blessing your life. Oh, you're not die in pain and shame. You'll die, oh Kayaba, with a testimony that the Lord has been with this man. They said, we know. I don't know what you know. I don't know what you know. They said, we know that our God is able to deliver us. And he will deliver us. He will deliver you. This is the assurance that the Lord will deliver us. This is the assurance. He will give us the victory. Do you have the assurance? By the power of the blood of Jesus, the one who died and he rose again, you will come out of whatever it is. This is the assurance. Our God is able to deliver us, and you will for sure deliver us. I see you shining. I see you rising. I see you giving a testimony. I see you telling them ni mazi ni God mazi na ya ukweli ile ya ukweli sio ile ya uko mtaani ni God ile ya ukweli ile inaweza elezewa hivi ndivyo God alikuja. Wachana na ile ya ukule ya kuosha miandarati. Kuna ile ya sawa sawa that ameikia na unaweza ukaelezea aliingia na akafanya hivi na akafanya hivi na sasa hona. This is what the Lord has done. And I tell you the truth, and God is not a faker. Every ayabashada, let everyone be a liar, but the Lord shall remain to be true. All the other gods, they are the works of men. They are just works of men. They cannot hear, they cannot speak, they cannot move. I have seen people kwa vindios wamebeba miungu yao. Miungu yao wameiweka kwa mabega. Mungu wetu anaweza tembea, anaweza sikia, anaona, anaweza saidia. Haitaji kubebwa na mwanadamu. Yeye ndiye anabeba wanadamu. That is why when that day came, even the heavy stone could not hinder Jesus from getting out of the grave. Oh, that's why I know God is lifting you again. God is doing something new again. God is honoring you again. God is hope. In that family, you'll be the savior. You'll be the deliverer. In that family, you'll show them the way. There is coming a day when they'll be saying, atuwezi ongea kama nani hajafika. Are you getting what I'm talking about? Watch our ongeas are easy. Watch out. Sometimes God will wait until they do whatever they have to do. They say whatever they have to say. And then he comes. Poof, and he shows them dust. We know that our God. And look at this. The king is serious. He is serious about the fire. But they have an assurance. They have an assurance. They are actually seeing the fire being made hotter. But they have a conviction in them. And they are answering back the king. Nobody would answer back the king. But they have courage to answer back the king. And tell the king, we know. We know that our God, look at Psalm chapter 34, verse 19. Psalm chapter number 34, verse number 19. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. So the righteous can also go through many troubles. The righteous can also be afflicted. The righteous can also go through something that is not nice. Bible says, but the Lord. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. But the Lord delivers him out of them all. There is not even one of them that will be left. That which is afflicting you right now, it will not be left in your life. Itukayazeta mashata yandi. That which even iyo ambayo aujui utafanya nini, it will not be left, it will be taken away. Mini, they may be very many. Maybe you are that person who is telling the others, mimi sijui Mungu ni nini inatendekanga kwangu, mimi kila wakati natepetianga na mambo mazito mazito. Lakini sasa wewe unaweza ingia kwa hii scripture, Biblia inasema mambo mazito yanaweza kuwa mengi, lakini Bwana, he will deliver you from them all. From them all. Not even one dimension of it will be left. Not even one will be left. Don't laugh at the righteous when they go through pain, because they will be delivered from everything. You will be delivered from every trouble. Assurance of winning. Assurance of winning. Have the assurance that no matter what, by the power of God, you may not know what to do, but the Lord knows what he will do. The Lord knows what he will do. So you get to that point whereby you despise the cross. You despise the challenge. You despise the pain because of the victory that you're seeing ahead of you. A man who has the conviction of winning, he does not over-concentrate on the troubles that he has. He does not over-concentrate on the negative that is happening. He worships and praises the Lord because he is able to see there ahead of him. There ahead of you, there is something good. There ahead of you, there is victory. There ahead of you, the Lord will deliver you. Ata zile ulikuta shosho na mami na dadi zikiwa finyiria, na wewe ukaingia kwa hiyo box zikaanzia kukufinyiria, the Lord will deliver you even from that. Have the assurance. And you need to grow above mere excitement and go to the level of strong convictions. Bible says Abraham, he had hope against hope. That even when everything looked hopeless, Abraham had hope. Even when nothing seemed as though it would work, Abraham within him, he knew, and God will do this thing. God will work out this thing. I pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You get to that point whereby no matter what, you are able to see the hand of God working over your life. Can somebody say amen? John chapter number 16, verse number 33. John chapter number 16, verse number 33. Jesus spoke to the disciples and he said, these things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. These things I've spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world, you will have tribulations, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. I have spoken these things to you. I have told you these things so that in me
So that in me you may have peace. Your heart may be settled. That you not be afraid, you may not be troubled. That in me you may have this conviction. You may have this conviction. That in me you may have peace. That in the world you will have tribulations, but be of good cheer. Be of good courage. Just look at the tribulation and smile. Why? I have overcome the world. Even that which is troubling you, I have overcome. I have overcome it. The Lord has given you victory already. The Lord has given you victory already. You look at yourself and you say, take heart. Jesus says, take heart. I have overcome the world. When he talks about the world, what does he talk about? Anything that is contrary to his will for you, he has overcome it. Anything that is contrary to his will for your future, he has dealt with it. He has dealt with it. And this is the assurance that we have. He has given us victory. This is the assurance we have. No matter the trouble, the Lord has given us victory. Victory is yours in the name of the Lord. I say victory is yours in the name of the Lord. Romans chapter number 8, verse number 37. Romans chapter number 8, verse number 37. Yet amid all these things, we are more than conquerors. Amakazona mazata. Katikati ya mambo haya yote, we are more than conquerors. We have already gotten victory. That is why we can keep moving. Because we know victory is ours. That is why we keep standing tall. Because we know that victory is ours. That is why we don't give up. Because we know that amid all these things, we are more than conquerors and gain surpassing victory through him who loved us. We are victory. We have more than we are more. We have been made. You have been made more than a conqueror. You are not just a conqueror. You are not just getting victory. You are more than a person who has conquered. Because the victory of Jesus is your victory. I wish you start looking at yourself differently. That when you look at yourself, you see a man who has overcome. It doesn't matter how it has been. You look at yourself. That's why personally I usually tell people this. It is time you start seeing the hand of God over your life. What does Satan has to do with you? You know, sometimes we magnify Satan so much. Tunamfanyanga nasikia vizuri sana. He knows he can do nothing. But we make him feel so nice. Oh, the devil has done this. The devil has done that. The devil... No, Jesus has also done something. And what Jesus has done is more powerful than what the devil has done. Actually, what Jesus has done, it destroys what Satan has done. Praise the name of the living God. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you have the inner conviction. Say inner conviction that I have victory. Can you say I am assured that I am winning? Say again, I am assured that I am winning. Yeah. I am assured that I am winning. Look at the guys that are about to be thrown into the fire. But they are saying, out of this, in this fire, we will come out. Kwa hii moto, we will come out. In this fire, we will come out. What, how do you see yourself? From today, start speaking yourself out of the fire. Start speaking yourself out of poverty. Start speaking yourself out of trouble. Start speaking yourself out of whatever it is. You will say to this mountain. So from today, start saying it. I am blessed of the Lord. I am lifted, my God. I am the redeemed of the Lord. The hand of God has delivered me. The victory of God is my victory. I don't know what you see about your life. I don't know what you see about your future.
I don't know what you see about your money. I don't know what you see about your family. I don't know what you see about your children. I don't know what you see about what God has done in your life. There is something better that is there for you. Hallelujah. Can you say again, I am assured that I am winning? Yeah. I am assured. Look at Akazuna Mashata. This guy you are seeing today, just look at him after 2 years from now. Just look at him. You will see what God can do. I tell you the truth. You will see what the Lord can do. This ministry, look at it after 2 years. You will see what the Lord can do. I tell you, some of you who are seated here, after 2 years, people will be amazed. Yeah. You may not be seeing it physically, but the Lord is working on it. The Lord is God is still a miracle working God. You just continue doing what you're able to do, but expect that the Lord will amplify something, that the Lord will do something. And I tell you the truth. I tell you the truth. There are people who will meet with you and they will not recognize you. Yeah. There are people who will meet with you and they will not recognize you. They see like it is you, but the kind of a car ambayo umechomoka, awafikiri unaweza toka kwa gari kama hiyo. They look, see as though it is you, but the kind of a house umetokelezea, hiyo estate, na wao wamepitia hapo na mboda mbonda, lakini wanaangalia, it looks like, lakini hawezi kuwa ametoka huku. I tell you the truth, a day is coming, and there are people who will not recognize you. I pray in the name of Jesus, may you be assured of the victory of God. God is a proud father, and he raises proud children. Ayaya. God is a proud father. He proudly says, watoto wangu wawezi wakaniomba mkate nikawapatia mawe. That is the kind of a God we serve. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that the grace of God will manifest in your life. The anointing of God will work for you. The grace of God will work for you in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray in the, I pray in Jesus' name. From today, you will walk tall. Ukiwa unajua, ya kwamba mimi, ata ninaweza bounce. Don't ask me about what I have in the pockets because my account has so much. Some of you, you will not be trending with the cash. Because the kind of money you need to spend in a day, haiwezi bebwa kwa mfuko. Haiwezi bebwa kwa M-Pesa. As I speak right now, I'm prophesying to your life. I'll be there to see it. I'll be there to witness of it. I'll be there to celebrate it. Some of you, I'll bless your houses. Some of you have dedicated your businesses. Some, I see you giving a car as an offering. Giving a piece of land and say, hii nimepeana kwa kanisa. Oh, God is lifting you. I see you say, I want to build a house for the Lord. God is lifting you beyond measure. And that is why I came to encourage you today. No matter what, hold on to the faith. I want us to stand on our feet in the name of Jesus Christ and just revitalize the assurance of winning in you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. By the speaking of your hands, just tell the Lord, God, Lord God Almighty, do it in my life that I shall not lose my hope, I shall not lose my faith. I am assured of winning in the mighty name of the living God. Some of you, kuna mambo ambayo umekua labda unayapitia, na unaona ni kama yamekukalia, declare, victory right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Declare victory, declare victory, declare victory. Declare that you're winning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, shaka para shota bayande, reke pashoka tabazita bayande, reke pashoka tabaye, eke teke teke te, eposha katabazola, eke pesha katabayanda, eke pesha katazola, eke pashota bayande, eke posha katabazira, repa kashoto bayenda, eke payanto bashera babayenda, repa kasheke tabazira. Repo shakete bezante, repo kashekete, ente bebebebe yando, repo shakete bezia, zakopa shakata, ende bebe yando robosheta, yapora kadaba shekete, zapora katazota mashante. Everybody pray in the mighty name of the living God. Declare your victory because you're winning. By the hand of God, you're winning. By the grace of God, you're winning. In the mighty name of Jesus. Everybody, open up your mouth in the name of Jesus. Talk to the Lord. Oh, sheke paya, eke pashonta babazira, eke pashota bazente, lepo shatebraya, repe kata sheketa yande, rapoka shekata, sapoye la bayante bozira, repe kato shekete, ente bebebebe yande rebeshate. Oh, thank you for the victory, mighty God. Thank you for grace. Thank you for favor. Thank you for breakthrough. Thank you for grace in the mighty name of Jesus. Epeshata ente boshane maya ente bebebebe shende epokoto shekete leke pora shete ente boshena mamaya lepo shakatabo repe shariba yande. Everybody bless the Lord, for he has given you the power, he's given you the grace, he's given you the victory in the mighty name of Jesus. Ashapa yanto mashekete. Oh, you deliver us from all the troubles. You set us free from every pain in the mighty name of Jesus. We give you the glory, we give you the praise, we give you the honor in the mighty name of Jesus. Ande boshate barabazota enta boshaketebe enteberebereberebosente leke boshate bazila reprokoshekete entebo yelebebebe ante reke boshaketa baze entebe kayaboshe ekapora shata eke payande boboboshente leporo Zotorobo, eporoberebe, eposhaketa bazira, rekeposhata, reposhata yande, repeke shekete, lekeporazete be yande, roba yarababoshe, enderebe shakorobo, lekeposhakata baze, lekeposhariba, entoboshete rebezira. We worship your name. We bless you, mighty God. We glorify your name, Jesus. We magnify your name, Lord. You're worthy of glory. You're worthy of praise. You're worthy of honor. You're worthy of adoration. We worship your name. We bless your name. We adore your name in the mighty name of the Lord. None like you, Jesus. None like you, our God. None like you, our Father. None like you, our Savior. You're worthy of all the glory. You're worthy of all the honor. You're worthy of all the praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Emashakapaya, emashatabaya, emashakarabaya, emashatabaraba, emashantabara, ekeposhata, eporashekete. We worship you, Jesus. We bless your name, my God. We adore your name, my God. We exalt your name, Lord. Oh, reba baba shandere. Oh, reba sheketebe. Oh, rebroshete rebebezante. Leke posha tabayande. Reposha kata. Oh, Jesus. We praise your name, Lord. We worship your name, Lord. We magnify your holy name. We glorify your holy name. We exalt your holy name. You're worthy of glory. You're worthy of praise. You're worthy of honor. You are worthy of adoration. Thank you for this breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Thank you for this victory. Oh, Shaparaya, Emoshakata. Thank you for the setbacks that have been which have been dealt with in the mighty name of the Lord. Thank you for the pain which has been dealt with in the name of Jesus. You've lifted us, you've blessed us, Lord, you've done us well. We bless your name, Jesus. We magnify your holy name. Let the Holy Spirit come upon us, Lord. Let your grace come upon us, Lord. Let your favor come upon us, Lord. I receive favor within God. I receive favor within man. I receive new strength in the mighty name of the living God. May my heart never doubt. May my heart never wander. In the name of Jesus Christ, I call on my Savior. I trust in you. My God and my Savior, I hold my heart in you. In the mighty name of the living God, Onda ba shanda baba, Onda baba baba shanta baba bayande, Onde be katoro boshenda, Reke posha dara baba yande, Reprokaya tabasheta, Zeke poraja. We worship your name, Jesus. We bless your name, mighty God. We glorify your name, Jesus. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Jesus. You are more, Aboshanda Baba Bazila. We worship your name, Lord. Father, we worship your name. Father, we bless your name. Father, I pray right now, let your grace and your anointing fall upon everyone who is this meeting today. Let the Holy Spirit touch everyone right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord God, Holy Spirit, I pray, touch the heart of everyone who is here today in a new way. Renew their focus, renew their faith. Take away worry, take away fear, take away unbelief, take away doubt. In the mighty name of Jesus, right now I pray. Lokapa sota mayande, let the inner eyes open up, that all God, each one of them may be able to see that which you're doing for them. Let everyone, my God, their ears open up, their understanding be quickened. In the mighty name of the Lord, let the anointing of the Lord come upon you right now. Just open up your mouth and bless the Lord. He's doing it. In the mighty name of Jesus, just thank him and bless him. Just give him honor, just give him glory, just give him praise. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh sharabanda bagaraba sota baya shekana mama mama sotara baba shanta shepoka sana mashoya rabayanda. Oh Jesus, we worship your name. Thank you, Lord. Now listen to me. Maybe you have never seen anybody who has believed in God and things have turned around. Wewe umeona wale wanakuanga na God fathers wamesaidiwa na uncles and the like. Watch Apostle Roy. Yeah, just watch me. Just watch me. If you feel like your faith is wavering, just follow after me. Just monitor me. Just watch me. I've seen God doing it before. And this time around, God is doing it in a greater way. Not just in my life or in one Jesus church, in your life. God is doing it in a greater way. You'll be amazed at the things that God will do in your life. You'll be amazed at the move of God. Actually, many will see. They will see it and they will honor you and God. I declare over your life, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let the anointing of God come upon you. The anointing that knows no barriers. The anointing that knows no limits. The anointing that cannot be hindered. I release upon you the power of God, the grace of God that breaks every chain. In the name of Jesus Christ, the grace of God that breaks every curse. The grace of God that destroys the works of darkness. In the name of Jesus, may your life start shining. May your life start becoming easier. May your life start changing. May doors start opening for you. In the name of Jesus, let that which was stored start moving forward. In the mighty name of the living God, let the power of God come upon your life right now to change your life, to lift your life. In the name of Jesus, I pray this month, let there be a month that you count a miracle from above. In the name of Jesus. And somebody say amen. 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 Yes, give the Lord praise. In the name of Jesus. The other day, I was asking the Lord, God, why have you given me the word and you don't give me people to preach to? And the other day the Lord showed me a vision. And then a congregation that was in this congregation is so new. There were very many people. Na nilikuwa nawaangalia naona wote wako very down kwa imani yao. Wako chini sana washikanishi mambo. And the Lord told me, this is why I am to give you the word first, because of these people. And I am assured in my heart. I am assured in my heart. Na pambele. I tell you the truth. What God will be doing, it will not just be known in Nairobi. It will touch the corners of this nation.